Welcome to the most disliked show on YouTube.
We tried an interview with Susie tonight.
It's too long.
Okay, just about how horrible James Corden is, what a horrible entertainer he is. So I tried to do an interview tonight about how horrible James Corden is. The footage is absolutely amazing because she defended James Corden, one of the worst entertainers that ever existed. She defended him tooth and nail, a total idiot. And when his show debuted following the Super Bowl one year, I said there's no way it'll possibly last. Of course, I underestimated the stupidity of the American public once again. Fall for a fat guy with an accent. A fat, feminine guy with an accent. And then that's all they need. They don't need irony. They don't need acerbic humor. They don't need anything. All they need is this idiot. So let's take a look at some of the horrible, horrible routines that James Corden does. Here he is. All his stupid idiot female fans, his morons. See? Idiots.
He's the subject of the new documentary on sequel, Truth to Power. Former Vice President Al Gore.
This is probably the first that James Corden probably doesn't even know who Al Gore is. He probably never saw an Inconvenient Truth. These idiots have never heard of him.
You a note on a cocktail napkin.
I got it. And our mutual friend Kevin Wall, who
yes.
did the Live Earth concert,
yeah.
gave me that napkin. I got in touch with you. That was just before you started your show.
We hadn't aired the show, and I couldn't believe that I was in a room with you, and I wanted you to know how much I loved your first film, and that I share the sentiments that you feel about the planet. And I said, I've got this new TV show. If you ever want to come down. And 2.5 years later, here it is. We're so thrilled that you're here. Thank you very much.
Is that a punchline?
We met before. We met at a play. That's right. Bars and a Trial on Broadway. And you've just been performing on Broadway.
Yes.
In an incredibly well-received run. And you were at the Belasco Theatre, which was famously... It's a haunted...
It's a famously haunted
People say it's haunted.
Yeah,
is it haunted?
Oh, it's absolutely haunted.
Oh, come on.
No.
Don't you know that haunted theaters are real, James?
But I was not a believer. I had been told about the ghosts at the Belasco.
She's now a believer, huh? She's now a believer in Scientology. If the internet didn't exist, this lady would be a Scientologist.
And legend is that during final dress rehearsals, that's when the ghosts come out. And so I'd forgotten this, and I was really playing with Jane Alexander, and I turned to Jane Alexander, and then I looked up to the upper balcony. There are two balconies there.
You can see she's getting chills right now just thinking about
it. Outside, and those doors were locked.
And I Classy-eyed.
And there was a woman standing in the front row, looking over, with a blue dress and gloves.
Oh my God, just thinking about it. It's real.
Please remember to subscribe and hit the dislike button at the bottom of the page.